Hello and welcome to the Virtual Pipe Organ Project. In this video, I'm going to be talking about a couple issues with the current version of Grand Org. We are currently on version 3.14.1-1. I am using Kubuntu 24.04 as my desktop operating system for my organ. I was previously using Arch Linux, but Arch Linux have since migrated to 3.14.1-1 yet in the AUR. And I've tried doing the GitHub, grabbing the links from GitHub to try to see if I can get that to work. And the only thing that would work would be an app image, but I have my own preferences on why I don't like using them. So I decided to switch over to the latest release of Kubuntu, and I was successfully able to get this latest version to run on it. So what I want to talk about is setting up the keyboards and the pedal board on this version of Grand Org. Things have been a little wonky for, I think, the past few point versions, where the most common complaints that I'm hearing about, and you can definitely see this from the comments on my very first video that I produced about a year and a half ago or so on installing and setting up Grand Org. And that is, once you do the detecting of the keyboards and the pedal board, the keys like to stick. So I'm going to actually show you that now. So we're going to program in my lowest keyboard to Grand Org here. So we're going to click on the Detect Complex MIDI setup. I'm going to hit the lowest key on my lowest keyboard. Okay, now I'm going to hit the highest key on my lowest keyboard. Okay, and then most of you will stop here and hit OK. Now I'm going to hit one note on the keyboard and watch what happens. Okay, it should be very evident to you that with this red outline here that the note is stuck. And this is the exact complaint that I'm hearing most of all. So to correct this, let's go back into our MIDI settings. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to change this lowest velocity to 1. And then hit OK. And you can see that right now, all the keys are working on my lowest manually. So for whatever the reason is, when you put the lowest velocity to 0, it's not sending the note off MIDI signal back to the computer when you release the note. And then for some reason, when the lowest value is 1, it actually does send out the MIDI signal for note off, allowing the key to release. So that's problem number one. Problem number two, and this is more for those of us who are using Novation launchpads, those of us who are using an organ console that has stop tabs rather than pull stops. And the type of tabs I'm talking about are the ones where they're like a toggle, so you hit the bottom of it, then the stop tab will press in and then come back out as a toggle, and then the stop will illuminate. So this next part is going to address those of us who have those type of issues. So I'm gonna work on programming my contrabass 16-foot here. So again, what we would be doing is hitting the detect complex MIDI setup. So then you'll hit the control, so to toggle on, and then to toggle off. And for the event here, we have 9x note. Now, if I was developing this, I would try to figure out a way so that when we do the detect complex MIDI setup, that if it's a pull stop, that would detect the various note on and note off signals being sent, so that depending if it was a pull stop or if it was a toggle switch of some sort, that would indicate that appropriately on the event. So then we would go to 9x note on toggle to fix that, so that way when you're set up the stops, you actually have the stop working. So this is the general setup that we would have here after doing the detect complex MIDI setup. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And then you're going to see the issue here quite quickly. So I'm going to press the stop, and immediately it toggled back off. So that's kind of the issue there. So then to fix it, we go to 9x note on toggle, click OK, and then you can see there we go. Now it's toggling on and off appropriately. So that is two of the problems that I have found that would affect, I think, 90% of GrandOrg users out there. And then the other issue that's been going on for approximately the last year. This involves more of us who are using Novation Launchpads. So, what a Novation Launchpad allows you to do is have stops programmed to it. You can set colors to the various pads. I've covered this on a previous tutorial, so please go back and look at my Novation Launchpad tutorials if you're not familiar with this. And those of you who are familiar with this will know exactly what I'm talking about here. So the beauty of it is if you're using different sample sets and you don't want to put labels on your pads, and let's say the labels aren't exactly sticking anyways, you can assign different colors to the pads. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and copy the current receive event. I'm going to change this event to 9x note. And now I can change my off value and my on value. So for these purposes, I'm going to use white. So off value is of 1 is going to give me a dim white light on the appropriate pad. I'm going to now tab over to the on value, give it a value of 3, which will give me a brighter white light. Okay, and that, so now I have the appropriate pad illuminated. So that helps with giving a visual representation of the stop layout on the launch pad to help take some of the guesswork out of the equation. Now, the only issue right now with this setup is if I had my entire launch pads programmed in with all the stops laid out how I want, and I go to close down GrandOrg or change to a different sample set, all the pads that I've programmed for each of the controls will remain illuminated with the whatever I've programmed in for the off value. Now, prior to a year ago, I could go to master controls, click on my save settings here, right click on the on button here, go to send, And then as you can see, I've already have set up the send information for the on the on button for the MIDI note 11, which corresponds to my contrabass, with the off value of being zero. Now, prior to a year ago, like I said, this would work. The problem now is it doesn't work anymore. And what I have done is I did use a program to watch the MIDI signals being sent as I'm loading grand.org and shutting down grand.org. And what's happening is the MIDI settings for the on button are getting sent before the MIDI settings for each of the stops. The reason why this is a problem is, well, the launch pads are not being de-illuminated. So if you're a grand.org developer that happened to stumble upon this video and you're watching this, a workaround, a fix for this would be greatly appreciated. I have opened up two new issues on the grand.org GitHub page regarding all these issues that were discussed in this video. So I'm going to stop here. I wish you all a great day, and hopefully this helps you get back on track with using grand.org, and happy practicing.